While there are a ton of sensors that you can get connected to Amazon's voice assistant in order to use their fantastic routines function, there are only a few that are $5. Hello automators, thanks for tuning in again. I'm Brian from Automate Your Life, and today I'm going to take the frustration out of automation and a lot of the cost out of automation, quite frankly, by telling you how to connect a system where you can go ahead and just get $5 sensors to trigger very complex automations. Now, what I'm actually talking about in terms of products is the Wyze system. And this is the Wyze Cam V2. You've probably heard about the Wyze Cam Pan, but you might not have heard about the Wyze Sense system. And we've talked about it here on Automate Your Life a number of times, but really what we're talking about there is a kit that you can go and buy for $20 US. And if you're outside of the US, you got to do some work here to get these products to you. But the Wyze Sense starter kit, $20, contains a couple of these contact sensors and a motion sensor and a bridge that connects into the back of a Wyze Cam. Now, once you have that Wyze bridge, you can go ahead and buy these sensors for $5 US. And this is where it becomes extremely powerful, because now you can connect it to Amazon's voice assistant and now use them within routine. If you want to go to that next level and you want to trigger something on, you can go ahead and you can use the Wyze plugs as well, and the Wyze bulbs, which are $10 as well. So you can get really complex automations into Amazon's voice assistant here. Now, of course, you can still use the Wyze application there, don't get me wrong, but what Amazon gives you access to is a whole nother set of actions that are far and away better than what Wyze gives you access to. So yes, you can connect directly through the Wyze system still, but when you connect to Amazon's voice assistant, I'll show you what you're going to get access to. Let me show you very quickly what the connection process is like. You go into Amazon's voice assistant application, you go up to the menu, and you go down to skills and games. Then you search for Wyze, which is W-Y-Z-E, and you go ahead and connect that skill or enable that skill, put in your Wyze credentials that you have already created when you installed all of those products. Now, if you don't know how to install all of those products, I do have a video that I will leave a link down in the description below, so you can go ahead and get Wyze Sense set up with your Wyze cams and have all of that working. Now, after I show you all the great parts of this, I am going to show you a couple of things that are kind of detractors to using it this way, but let's go in depth now with what you can do within routines with these sensors. First off, you'll need to find your devices, or you will need to start by creating a new routine, but it's good to know what has been discovered through the process you just went through. Now, once you have discovered those devices, you can actually go in to see your cameras, any of the Wyze cameras, through the camera section, or the lights if you have the Wyze bulbs, through the light section. But in order to find the sensors, you'll have to head into all devices. Now, mine happens to be called Basement Stairs Motion, and this is one of the motion sensors that you can get with this Wyze Sense system. So you can go into the settings for that device, you can adjust the name, you can even enable and disable it, but you can also tell that it is connected through Wyze Home and their service. So that's how you know it's one of the motion sensors coming from that system. Now, we could hit create a routine down below within the device settings here, or we can go into the basic menu in the application and go into routines there. Once we're inside of routines, now we're creating some of this complex automation that we've talked about. Now, you're going to go up to the top, hit that plus button, and this is the start of creating really complex and fantastic automation. What you're going to hit next is when this happens, and this is where you're going to choose your smart home, and this is where all your different sensors or your triggers, all your trigger devices exist here. So you'll be able to see both the contact and the motion sensors within this. I also have the secret event sensor here, which is a contact sensor. So you can see that I could choose either a motion or a contact sensor. And now I'm going to choose that basement stairs motion detector and go ahead and choose that motion was detected. Once I hit next, we're back to the main page, and I can go ahead and rename this entire automation if I'd like. I can also set times and days, that time period that I want this to execute within, so I can really limit this to only happen in the evenings if I'd like on the weekends. The next thing we want to do is go into the actions that we are going to execute. And for me, I'm going to choose just a couple of things here, but you could literally do 10 different actions with this. So you can see the full list here where you can get your voice assistant to say something. You can have it read the calendar, the date, or the time. You can actually change some of Amazon's some of your devices settings there, like do not disturb. You can have it go through, read your email summary and get good news. Amazon Guard, you can trigger that on. If this and that is also a very powerful thing that you can go ahead and trigger applets there. Now you can do that with the Wyze service directly, so maybe something you don't need. You can also trigger messaging, so you can actually send an announcement to your Amazon devices, have a notification trigger there as well. The next things, you can start music, news, or even skills, so you can trigger certain skills. And then of course, smart home sounds, traffic, you can have it wait a minute, or you can have it wait an hour if you'd like, and then you can get the weather. Now, for the purposes of this demo, I'm just going to go into smart home and I'm going to control a couple of lights. So I'm going to have to add two actions here. I could do it by group if I wanted to, but I just wanted to show you that you can add multiple actions here. So I'm choosing basement stairs in this case, and I could power it on or off based on motion. I can set the brightness. I can also ramp the brightness over a certain amount of time if I'd like to kind of create a morning routine here where it wakes me up. And I can set the color temperature, which is very important with the Wyze bulbs, or I could set the color in general if it was, say, a Philips Hue bulb. Now, once I've added that, I can do the same with a second action here with basement stairs at the bottom. That's my secondary light here. So we can trigger on multiple of these, and then we could have it do any of those other actions. So I think you can see just how powerful that is going to be for you with the Wyze $5 sensors here that you can get from their website. Now there is one drawback with all of this, and that is speed, because what you're actually doing is you're going from these sensors and then you're going to the bridge that's in the back of the Wyze camera. There's a little processing that goes on and then it's sent off to the Wyze servers for execution, basically. So you have to get all of that to happen before it comes back, goes through Amazon's voice assistant application or their voice assistant, and then triggers the action. So there's a lot going on, and I probably didn't even get that whole path exactly right here. I was just kind of ad-libbing it, but I think you get the point. There's a little bit of a delay and it's much quicker through Wyze's system. So if you just want to turn on the Wyze bulb, still do that in general through Wyze's system. But if you connect Amazon to Philips Hue, that response is very quick after this has gone to Wyze's server. So there's a couple of ways for you to make it a little bit quicker. And over time, I think this will get quicker as Wyze improves their cloud service in general. They are working on that right now, and it's a bit of a problem for the platform. But I'm getting about a second of a delay out of a motion or a contact sensor by the time I have that trigger within Amazon system and actually see the action. So it's not that bad. It's just something right now that's a little bit longer than some of you might expect. Now, the next thing you're probably going to want to know is how you can use these sensors in a lot of different ways. And we actually created a three-part series for how to use these devices with the Wyze cams. And we have a ton of information and knowledge here and ideas for you with your Wyze system. So go ahead, watch that playlist that's up on screen. Otherwise, check the news for Amazon's voice assistant, which is also on screen, to get all the latest features and updates from them. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching. And of course, don't hate, automate.